salon and spa. Today we're going to be doing a strip application with strip lashes. I had to figure out what was good for me as far as applying lashes. I couldn't do it myself on top, so I took a better way, a better approach for me. Lash like me. That's what we're going to be talking about today. My way of applying strip lashes. Lashes is a hot commodity right now. The ladies are dying to get them. It's a great add to your revenue, and it's something that most ladies don't want to do without. Special occasions, just life itself is great for lashes. Any day is great for lashes. So come on, let's get started. I'm glad to have you. Okay, ladies, what we're ready to do is do a strip application for your clients. You want to start with a consultation. You want to ask them, what are they looking for? What would they like to do? Where are they going? And some of them will trust you with your instinct. And some already have an idea. Some may come with lashes. But what you want to do is provide them with the best service by consulting with them and trying to get in their head, trying to figure out what they would like. Is it their first time? That's always exciting. Would they like to come back? You want to incorporate all of that in your consultation, okay? So what we're first going to do, we want to create a workspace. You want to have a clean palette to apply your lash adhesive. You can keep toothpicks because toothpicks are sanitary. It's inexpensive. You use one per client. Q-tips, that would be for any cleanups. Sometimes your clients will cry. They're good for catching tears. You got your small scissors, clean tweezers, hand sanitizer. You always want to make sure you're clean, and you want to create a clean workspace that's impressive to your clients, and it's also good for you. Okay, let's choose our lashes. Today we're doing strips right now, so Ms. Tawana, what would you like to have? You want to be a little extra? You want somewhere special? Okay, so Ms. Tawana, she's going somewhere special. Is this your first time, Ms. Tawana? Okay, this is not her first time. So, what is your norm?
Short
and light. Okay. That's great to work with when you're doing a consultation. Some people want to be pushed outside their box, and some people are comfortable in their box. But because she's going somewhere special, let's push the envelope a little bit. Let's go from doing our norm, which is like flirty is something that I like. It's kind of simple. It's got a little length, but it's not as thick. But since we have something special going on, let's try our starlet. They give us a little bit more depth. It's a little bit more density. Okay, so what you want to do is remove your lashes from the pack. Put under your pack. Use your tweezers. You want to remove from the grid. Try to lift it a little bit. Squeeze. Pull slow. Let it rest there. Okay, get your other lash. Okay. And you want to do that before you do your adhesive, because you don't want your adhesive to dry. Always look for a hypoallergenic adhesive, and you want to squeeze a little bit on your palette. Always like more than enough for some reason. It just makes me feel better. With your clenched hands, you want to get your toothpick. Always do two, so you can be ready just in case one falls on the floor or something like that. You don't have to, you know, stop your whole full application to do so. Okay, let's get started. Client to hold their head back just a little bit, and you kind of want to stroke their lashes. Make sure their lashes are all in the same direction. Some people will have curly. Curly people don't mean that they can't get lashes. It's just that you want to make sure they're in the right place. And what we're going to do, I'm removing extra adhesive. That's something you want to look out for too. Okay, while the client is, you lift their lid up just a little bit. You don't want to jack it because that would also change the length of the lash. So just hold it up a little bit. Ask your client to look down. The reason why you want to ask your client to look down is that when you come towards their eye, their natural instinct is going to be to look and bat their eyes.
and you don't want that. When they look down, it takes their focus off of what's coming towards their face. So as your client is looking down, you're gonna hold your lash up like this because you're looking to see if it's gonna fit. This is a perfect fit for Miss Tawana. So we don't have to cut the edges off. We can just go full out for the application. Okay, so once you get that done, you want to come on over, get your toothpick, get a bead of glue on the toothpick, and start to spread it across the lash. That is too thin, you will want a little extra, okay? So if you have to do a little thin layer first, and then come back, because you don't want it too thick and you don't want it too thin. This is perfect. It kind of beads up a little bit, but that's perfect there. So put your utensil down, wear your toothpick. You want to wave it a little bit. Blowing your lash is not sanitary because, you know, that's coming off the human body, and we just don't want to create that for our client. And no problem. You want to stay away from all problems. You want everything to stay clean cut. So just wave your lash around a little bit. And what you're doing is you're allowing your glue to get a little tacky for your application. So have your client to hold their hair back just a little bit, not so that their neck are hurt or anything. You want to lift the lid just a little bit. Ask your client to look down, which is something you may have to constantly remind your client because they will feel like they're looking down, but they're not looking down. So tell them to look down, try to find something to focus on because they can use your phone or anything because that is very important in your application. So what you want to do is take the glue, stroke the lash a little bit. Just create a little bit of foundation for your lashes to lay on because you're going to be doing glue to glue. I like to do this. I didn't do it at first, but at first I started doing it because it made it the application easier. So what you're going to do, holding your tweezers in the middle of the lash, you're going to apply the middle first. And the edges are going to be holding down. It's okay for your client to bat their eyes just a little bit. Ask them if you have to blink, blink. But do not squeeze the eye closed because that will push the lash off. Glue will get into the eye and you'll get a whole little thing of irritation and you'll have to wait for the eye to stop tearing and all. You will have some tear people, which is okay. That's when you want to take, if you do have someone that's crying, you'll want to take one of your Q-tips. All you have to do is apply it to the corner of their eye and it will catch the tears. You don't have to wipe it. It's amazing until you try it. When your client is crying, some people's tears may come down the side, but for the most part, if they're tearing up, take your Q-tip, dot it right there in the corner and it will catch every tear, I promise you. Okay, so once you get the middle, you want to take your tweezers, push it up for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Every time you push it up, you want to hold it for 3 seconds. And you want to squeeze that. You can squeeze from the middle out because that is applied. And your inside is hanging. So you want to take your tweezers, grab the cosmetic lash, push up, hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, and squeeze. Squeeze. Now in your squeezing, it's very important that every time you squeeze, you have to look at your tweezers and clean them off because if you get wet glue on your tweezers and go to squeeze another one, it's gonna cause a buildup, then it will be sticky and you could possibly squeeze your lash and then when you unsqueeze it, your lash will be stuck to your tweezers. So every time you squeeze, clean. Maybe you can get 2 squeezes out, but you can tell as you get more advanced that, okay, I need to clean these tweezers. And here we have, our lash is applied. Okay? So, that's that. Beautiful, natural. I applied a black line, which you don't because this is for the video we did, makeup or whatever. But if you want to cause a little extra drama with your lashes, apply your black line first or afterwards, and I mean, you would be in there. That is my absolute fave. But these lashes are nice. They are applied. And this is a good example here. She had one lash hanging out. This lash can be the end of your lash application. You always want to check and see. Sometimes if your client feels a little uncomfortable, you may need to come up under here and make sure that the lash is not touching the waterline. Their waterline is their light line on the outside of the eye. It's extremely sensitive and you don't want to touch it. So getting a little extra squeeze in. These lashes can last you 3 days, 1 week, 2 weeks. It's up to the client. My clients absolutely love it. It's great money behind the chair. If you want to create your own side eyelash business, it's awesome. All of my clients love it. Above the individuals, above the semi-permanents, all of my clients come right back to strips because it's convenient. You can sleep on them better. They just last longer, so much better. We're going to start our second application, putting on the other lash. We already know that it's a perfect fit because it fit the other one. But just to be sure, God made us all different. One of your client's eyes may be smaller or bigger than another. Let's just be sure. Perfect, perfect match. Okay, let's come over to our workspace. You're going to take a toothpick. Take a bead of glue and you want to come down the side of your lash. And let me mention, ladies, before you apply your lash, let's be sure there is no extra adhesive on the lash. Because that little bit will throw you all off and you'll just mess up your whole. I use the back of my hand a lot to keep my lashes, just to let them sit for a second while the glue get a little tacky. So you want to wave it around like you did the first time. Come back over to your client. Ask your client to, well, you take your lid, their lid, look, take it up, ask your client to look down. And let's start. We're going to stroke the lash a little bit, just a little bit. And that'll be the reason why you want to put a little extra glue on it, but not too much. So we got that. Make sure it's even. And we're going to apply the middle. One, two, three, four, five. Come to the edge. One, two, three, four, five. Squeeze and clean your tweezers and do the edge. One, two, three, four, five. After that, you're gonna come down the line and squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze. Remember to check your tweezers for any excess glue. That little bit can throw your whole application off. Remember where you stopped, come on down. Clean it even if you can't see it. Squeeze, squeeze. So when you're squeezing your lash, your client's lash and the cosmetic eyelashes together because you're creating a bond. And we're done here. Just like before, beautiful application. Got a little drama around the eye, give it a little extra definition, a little thickness. I love it. These are perfect for Tawana and her evening out. Let's come to the front to see how she's looking. Yes, Miss Tawana, she's batting her eyes. She got it going on. She's ready for her evening out. And let me show you the front here. Look down, Miss Tawana. You want to make sure it's right aligned. The waterline. Your waterline is here. It's extremely sensitive. You don't want your client to go out with their lash touching that. So you want to hit the eyelash right at the lash line. Don't go any further. Like I say, it's a learning experience. Once you do it once, you're going to do it again. But you're perfecting the craft of strips, lashing it like me. This is how I taught myself to do my lash application because I couldn't do it on the top. So I was like,
but I can't do it on top. How am I gonna wear lashes? How am I gonna do it where I'm comfortable? And that's when I came up with Lash Like Me. I went under the eye. It's something different. You can go to your local nail salons. They don't know this application. This is something that you can do. You can do for your friends. You can make money on the side. It's absolutely amazing. Make money behind the chair. Everyone loves it. All of my clients love the way that I do these lashes. It's a great technique. It's been working for me, and I hope it worked for you. Let's take another look at Tawana.
And look down. Okay, so for my clients that may be wearing these extensively, I do one small trick. I get another clean Q-tip, and I just get a bead of glue, and I add it to the edge. And what you're doing is just locking in
the edges,
because naturally those are going to be the first to come apart. You can just put a little bead there and let it dry. It will naturally dry flat into the lashes. You want to do it on both sides. And if you feel like you pick up an extra little, too much glue, just kind of dot it just so you want to hit it on the tip. Like I say, it's going to dry naturally. It's going to dry flat. And it's going to dry black. So there we have it, ladies. Enjoy. Your client enjoy. There's going to be a lot of people giving you compliments. It's a great definition for your face. Lashes don't make you, but they help. It makes you feel beautiful. It's something some people like to try. Girls get together and try it just to have a girls' night out. It's great for even out on the town, just the weekend, whatever you like. But here's my application. Lash Like Me is going to be great for you and those around you. Be blessed. Hi, ladies. So it's your turn. Now it's time for you to know how to apply beautiful lashes to yourself, because you don't want just your clients to look good. So we're going to start off with the mink effect. These are my all-time favorite. They give me a little action, you know, a little depth with the hairs. The density, which means thickness, is thicker than what most ladies want. I mean, you have all kinds of lashes. Just pick your kind. So what you want to do is you're going to remove them from the paper. From the grid. And this is something that, you know, it's no big deal. Just take your time. I'm going to remove them from the grid. Be careful. Take it by the tip and then pull slowly off. When you take your lashes off the grid, sometimes it'll have a straight look. So what you want to do, take your tweezers off for a second, just bend them back into place. Also, sometimes the lashes, when they, the adhesive that they use to stick to the grid, sometimes it can be a little thick. Just make sure there's no excess adhesive on it, which these are good. So the first thing you're going to do, take your tweezers and hold them in the middle of your lash. You're going to then come to the mirror, take a finger, lift your eye. Too much lifting will create a concave look, so you just want to just a little bit. Just lift a little bit. Hold your lash up here, and what you're looking for now is your measurement. You don't want your eyelash too far inside, and you don't want it too far on the outside. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a little bit off each side to create a better fit, okay? Use your scissors, your clean scissors. I'm going to take just a little bit off. Sides and the front, which is always good. Say your lashes did fit perfectly, it's always good to take a little bit off the tip, off each edge. It just kind of take away from the extra adhesive that's on the that's already on the grid. So let's try our measurement again. Let's make sure that it's perfect. You're not too far on the outside, you're not too far on the inside. It is perfect. Okay, so hold your lash up. You kind of grab at it just a little bit to be sure that there are no loose hairs from you cutting it. That's the worst that you want, is a loose hair to get in your eye. You cannot
survive it. You would have to remove it and do it again. So to save time, let's make sure all of those are gone. So we're going to use our adhesive. Use a toothpick. And you're going to go around the edge, the bottom, the core, the ridge, whatever you want to call it, of the lash. I like to come all the way across. You don't want it to be too flat. And when I say flat, that means you want it to bubble up just a little bit, but you don't want too much. And as you get more advanced, you can choose your application of adhesive, but this here is perfect for anyone. Okay, so once you put your glue on the edge of the lash, you want to wave it a little bit. Blowing, trying to speed up the time to allow your glue to get a little tacky, is unsanitary. So just wave it a little bit and give it a little time. And then, let's go. Tweezers in the middle, because the first place you want to place your lash is in the middle. Make sure it's even. And also, this is what's very key. Take some of that glue and just take your lash and stroke your lashes just a little bit. Just a little bit. That'll kind of give it a glue-to-glue type of feel, and it'll help your application. So put it in the middle. Hold for about 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. If you're not sure, do 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And see, the middle is up. The front is hanging and the back is hanging. So what you want to do is take your tweezers, lift it up, hold the edge up. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're there. Let's get the middle. Hold. You want to push it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now, it's very important, ladies, because what you're going to learn is this line right here, this is called your waterline. It is extremely sensitive, and you don't want to touch it. I'm telling you, you're going to mess up. That's what's going to make you perfect. But before I get into that, let's squeeze our lashes. Take your tweezers. Always make sure your tweezers open up, because you can't work with tight tweezers. So if you feel like, you know, your tweezers are too tight, just pull them open a little bit. Okay? Slide in and make sure the point is this way, because when you press, you need to press. It's just one of those things you'll just understand once you do it. Slide between your lashes. Press. 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 And once you do that, you feel a slight tightness with your eyelash, and you can tell that it's on good. How am I looking? Very nice. Give you some definition around your eye. And you're almost done. At your own discretion, you can squeeze more. That'll make you feel more secure. I like to squeeze at least 3 or 4 more times. It's several things that's going to happen, ladies, while you're doing your own lashes. While you're squeezing your lashes, you may even squeeze the skin. You can possibly put it too close to your waterline. All of that helps you learn what not to do the next time. It may even happen the next time, but it is worth perfecting. Okay, let's go to the next lash. You want to do the same thing. Remove from your grid. Like I say, it's kind of straight, so we're going to take a second, and we're going to bend it for a couple seconds so we can get that shape back. I'm assuming both of my eyes are the same length and size, but let's just be sure. And it seemed like it fit, but ladies, what you don't want to put your lash too close to that inside. It is going to irritate you. It is not meant for that. When your lash closes, it goes in. And you will see that when you work with your clients and as you learn to tell your clients what to do and what not to do. But when your lash, when you open your eye, it goes open and it goes in like this. So if you have that lash all the way on the inside, it's not gonna have nowhere to go. So save yourself the time and do not put the lash that close to the inside of your eye. Your clients is gonna try to make you, they're not, I don't have no lashes close to the inside. You're not supposed to. Even your natural lashes are very fine once you get close to the inside, and God did it for a reason. So let's proceed. I'm gonna take a little bit off the front and a little bit off the back. I'm gonna knock away those loose hairs. I'm gonna measure again. Always, before you apply your glue, always check your measurement. Always. Perfect. Let's go. Always make sure all your loose lashes are gone. It will mess up your application. Okay, using your toothpick again, dipping your adhesive. You want to come all the way across. You want it to be an even amount all the way across. Okay, let's wave it. Remember, blowing is not sanitary. So just gonna wave it a little bit. Okay, I think that's good. Tweezers in the middle, because that's where you're gonna push up first. Okay. Lash like me. Place it in the middle first. Once you stroke your hairs with a little of that glue, hold. 1, 2, 3. In blinking, you have to master that. You have to get your stare eye. That's what I call it. Your stare eye. It's like you just have to act like you in the zone, okay? So I did the middle. We're gonna do the outside. It's kind of like a lift and push. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. And when you're doing that holding, you're not trying to squeeze your lash into the cosmetic lash. Not at this time, okay? So the front is still hanging. So once you do your middle, the back and front will be hanging. Then you push your back up. And then you're gonna put your front up, keeping that stare eye. You're gonna have to blink sometime, but you're still gonna have to blink to the point to where, hold that, 1, 2, 3. And we're on. I'm loving it. These are my favorites. We're gonna squeeze the inside first. Either way, you're gonna learn. I prefer to do the inside, sometimes I'll do the outside, but it's a certain time limit that you have to squeeze. So as soon as you get that last side up, do your squeezing, your multiple squeezing. And something else is very important to put on your lips. Always keep your tweezers clean after every squeeze, because your tweezers may pick up some wet glue. And if that glue dries almost and touches the glue, it's like spandex. It's gonna grab a hold of what you've already applied, and you do not wanna do that. So after each squeeze, clean your tweezers. Come back again, squeeze. In the beginning, you're gonna squeeze your meat. It's gonna hurt, you're gonna tear up. But you're gonna do it perfect. Am I ready? All right, so what we just done was apply to ourselves, our own DIY, make ourselves look good. Can't just be making our clients look good, we gotta look good too. So what better way to perfect it than to perfect yourself first, and then you can be of better service to your clients.